Huge news in the world of mixed martial arts. The UFC announcing the return of one of the greatest mixed martial arts fighters to ever compete. And the great George St. Pierre, we got Lando Venata
here.
Hi, guys.
How you doing, brother?
Rock and roll, brother. Some hilarious stuff there. The return of George St. Pierre. Word is he's set to take on Michael Bisping, 185 pounds. George St. Pierre, the former 170-pound champion, says he was willing to drop to go to 155 pounds, decides to move up to 185 pounds to take on Michael Bisping. A massive fight. What do you believe George St. Pierre has been working on in anticipation of his return?
Well, he told us he's been really working on the distances and the range management of his original martial art, which is karate. And so that's something he's been exploring in his off time a little bit, and that makes a lot of sense because that's sort of current right now. You have to understand footwork and distance and control that type of space now. You have to be able to do it to fight these days. So it makes sense that George has been working on that. You know, if he was still fighting and he hadn't taken 3 years off, and suddenly he announced he was going to go for the 185-pound title, all the conversation would be about going up in weight. But because he's had this time off, the conversation is going to be about his return. But I mean, Michael Bisping is an enormous man, and this is an enormous task.
Why do you believe that this is the fight for George St. Pierre? Is it a legacy fight? Become another person like Randy Couture and BJ Penn and Conor McGregor to be a two-division champion? Does he believe that, you know, another massive fight, get yourself ready for Michael Bisping, and then the fight that people have been talking about for years and years and years in a fight with Anderson Silva? What do you believe is George St. Pierre's motivation?
So let's compare. I think we can get the answer to this by comparing this fight with Bisping to a fight with Anderson Silva. Fight with Anderson Silva, legacy fight, big money fight, huge publicity fight. People are excited about it. And potentially, because Anderson is older now, might be an easier fight in some ways. Also, Bisping, we saw beat Anderson Silva. The difference with this one is there's the title. And to me, that's evident. The fact, why are you fighting Bisping instead of Anderson Silva or other fights, is to get that second belt. And I think that's the difference.
One of the things we've seen from George St. Pierre, one of his keys to success, has been the takedowns, his double leg takedowns, his powerful drive through. Is he going to be able to do that against Michael Bisping? As you pointed out, Michael Bisping's massive. He fought at 205 pounds before, and he's faced a lot of quality wrestlers during his time.
Hey, man, he took Chael down. You know what I mean? Years back. And defended a lot of takedowns against some of the best wrestlers in the world. Would you be blown away if you saw George out, dude, move around, be light on his feet, and then all of a sudden come driving straight in, Bisping's legs go flying up in the air, and boom, take him right to the ground? Would you be surprised?
I would not be surprised.
No. But would you also be surprised if Bisping shook off that first one, shook his finger at him, and suddenly George found himself in a different world? Neither one of those outcomes would surprise me. That's why we start getting super pumped about the dynamics of this fight.
Do you believe that George St. Pierre has laid out a timeline, a wish list, if you will, or is it just take things one fight at a time? Because in order to get to the Conor McGregor fight, you have to win this fight with Michael Bisping. Or do you?
I mean, so these guys now have the ability to lay out their future. And we used to say one fight at a time. But now we've seen success from people like Conor, even Bisping himself, lay out the future, but take the single steps on the way there. We know, and you're going to hear it all week long as people catch up with George and talk to him, he wants Bisping, and then he wants McGregor. And I don't think he's going to be shy to say that. He told us that sitting around having a couple beers with him 4 months ago. And he told us that 8 months earlier than that. So we know that's what he's thinking. And I don't think he's going to be afraid to say it publicly.
I know a lot of people are going to be furious when it comes to Michael Bisping and the 185-pound division, because a lot of people believe that Yoel Romero deserves a crack at Michael Bisping. Jacare deserves his crack at Michael Bisping and the 185-pound championship. A lot of people want to see the rematch, the rubber match with Luke Rockhold and Michael Bisping. Nobody cares about things being fair. Michael Bisping has cemented his legacy. He's going to go down as a UFC champion and one of the highest earners in mixed martial arts. Is that what it's about for a lot of these guys that have been around the game for such a long time?
Would we like to live in a world where the number one guy, the best guy in the world, that one fights two?
Yeah.
Of course we would. We're purists. We love the purity of the sport. We want to see Jacare fight for the title. We want to see Damian Maia get the next crack at the winner of Wonderboy versus Woodley. That's what we want. But we don't get what we want. There's evidence everywhere around us that the world is not fair. So we accept that, and we get excited about the fight that's here, because this fight's happening. This fight's been announced. If we sit around talking about what could have been, that's a distraction. This is an exciting fight. The world is unfair. I guess we have to accept it.
George St. Pierre also told us that he's going to go back to his roots, try to incorporate more karate into his mixed martial arts game. Michael Bisping, he's going to come out as soon as that bell goes, he's going to make it a stand-up affair where he's going to try to beat up the French Canadian. Do you believe that George St. Pierre is going to be forced to fight a stand-up game in this fight?
He may well be forced to fight a stand-up game. And before that loss to Matt Serra, George was evolving as one of the great strikers in fighting. And then they learned that there was less resistance if he took people down and beat them up from in guard. It became the path of least resistance for George St. Pierre. But he knows how to fight on the feet, and he may well have to in this one. I mean, I don't know. He'll probably bring in a Chris Weidman and some guys of Mike's size. But it's a whole different game when you get in there with a Michael Bisping. Michael Bisping will be once again, as he always is, underestimated over and over again, and probably will be the underdog in the Vegas odds. And to me, that's crazy. Michael Bisping is the champ. He's beat Anderson Silva. He beat Dan Henderson. He knocked out Luke Rockhold. And everybody made him the underdog in every one of those fights. And we're all going to do it once again, I'm sure.
A very exciting fight at 185 pounds. It will be the return of the welterweight great George St. Pierre. He's set to move up to 185 pounds to take on the current champ, Michael Bisping. The UFC has not announced that fight, but they are sure that it's going to go down sometime in 2017.